Thanks.
Ready?
Yeah,
okay, let me know if I win. All right, as Jason said, I've been doing social media for a few years. I started off at Linux Pro Magazine, and so this is a summary of what I've learned. This summer, I heard at an event, I don't believe in social media, and I have really good news. I've seen it, it's totally real. And so I'm gonna tell you, you should believe in social media. Regardless of what kind of open source project you have, you might be overthinking it if you don't believe in it. So I'm just gonna give you some of the down and dirty tricks I've learned over the years, so that if you don't have a communications professional on staff or a marketing person on staff, you can have somebody who's able to do some functional social media that helps your project. Even if you prefer to hang out in IRC, you can be directing people to your IRC channels by using social media and letting them know that they exist. So first of all, you want to share relevant, interesting, and accurate information. Consider your social media streams to be your own little publications, and so make sure you're curating what content you have in there. You don't want to just be off on whatever topic. Make sure that you're highly focused on whatever your project is and the focus of your project is. Also, you want to make sure you stay on message, even with your retweets. So if you're retweeting something relevant to your project, be sure that you check the link and make sure it's actually a relevant link and a current link, because often people are sending out tweets that are outdated to articles that are no longer current or to a previous release of a project or software. Also, craft the text. The title of whatever somebody wrote as their blog post is not necessarily the best content for you to be putting on an 140-character tweet. Make sure that all they have to do is hit retweet and they can send out the exact thing that you wanted them to send out whenever possible. I personally won't hit retweet if I have to go in and reword the whole tweet. So use hashtags and refer to other people's accounts, but you also don't want to overdo it. Anytime you see a whole bunch of hashtags, it's like screaming, it's like all caps, and it's usually from somebody who's in marketing and not necessarily in community on a project. So be very selective in the hashtags you're using. Avoid PR verbiage. People will send that to you all the time in marketing speak. Talk like you would normally talk to somebody who's working on your project. Please don't do any of the Upworthy stuff. I hate it, and I want it to die. Numbers do well, and how-to tweets do well. You'll see that on Opensource.com. These were number 1 and 2 the week I was pulling this example. Note about Facebook, unless you're marketing and have a budget to spend on marketing, I would avoid it. I mean, I would go ahead and send stuff out, but I wouldn't dedicate a lot of time to it. For every 1,500 stories a person might see when they log on to Facebook, the news feed only displays about 300 because of the algorithms that Facebook is using. Part of being on social media is a social, which means you don't just send stuff out all the time. You need to retweet, reshare, respond, and reply. So, like I said, make sure that resharing your message is very easy. Make sure you reply to people who have questions or commenting. Make sure that you are giving credit for people who have actually sent you the original information and let followers know where you heard about it first. Grow your reach. Ask your network to share particularly important content. If you go to the Linux_Pro Twitter account today, for example, you'll see that they shared a tweet that I wanted them to share about the new Women in Open Source Award here at Red Hat, and they did that because I just sent them a note and said, hey, will you send this out? Consider the schedule. If you're trying to talk about an event that you're hosting in Paris and all of your tweets are going out in East Coast time, you're missing everybody who's actually going to go to your meetup in Paris. So make sure you are scheduling all of your tweets to hit the time zone that is most relevant if you're talking about an event, for example. Avoid scandal. I use 2 computers when I work every day. If I'm doing something personal, it's on the computer over on my right. And if I'm doing something work-related, it's on the computer on my desktop. And that's another good reason to recheck those links, because occasionally people will send out really naughty links in well-meaning tweets. And measure success. These are examples of how I've been measuring success of the Red Hat Open account, which is one of the accounts I manage. I keep an eye on about 34 accounts in the open source and standards team at Red Hat. And then I have a spreadsheet where I kind of do an update every week on and just keep an eye on how successful we are. And then make sure you promote all of your accounts. This is an example of promoting all your accounts. Do it at a conference if you're giving a talk, or make sure it's on your business card or on your blog. Do as I say, not as I do, because these aren't actually listed on our blog right now, but they will be. So, and that's it. Do I win? Yes.
Yeah.